Yung sabi niya, akala ko ba no boyfriend since birth ka, pero ba't parang sanay na sanay ka? Like, do you know me? Do you know what I've been through to say those things? I started filtering comments. I've been in a very dark place recently. Yung kailangan mo magpakatatag so people won't think na nasasaktan ka, but you are. You do get hurt. I know, they know, that I'm hurting. I started modeling when I was 70. So, dun pa lang, I experienced rejection. Which is, yun lang sinasabi ng mom ko na parang, if ever na-reject ka, huwag ka ma-discourage kasi it means that God is planning something bigger for you. So, dun pa lang, I was a happy kid. I didn't care if no one, if you don't like me, I'm okay. I'm still gonna like you. I tried to find the good things in a person. Tapos dun ako nag-start. I didn't believe in myself before. Going inside, I was malapit akong mag-give up. Like, hotel arrest, I was like, can I really do this? Kaya ko ba to? And parang ma-handle ko ba to? Because I know that people are gonna watch and I know that I am something. I know sa sarili ko na I'm not normal. I'm very vocal, opinionated. I know that people won't expect much from me, but I know I would do something na would shock them. I was tall and anything from the usual. Kasi nga, I'm not normal. I know, like, from the start. I'm very loud, madaldal, talkative, dark skin. So, yung mga inaasala nila sa akin before. Actually, hindi akong susuklay. I was very boyish. Running around. May sipon, ganun. Then, joke lang. I didn't care about what I looked like sa labas. I was fifth grade noon. I wanted to transfer ng school. Kasi I was bullied, and then I think that one time they locked me in a room, like five guys, dark room, like they were ganging up on me na, and then I kicked the other and then I ran, I bolted outside. That was the yung pinaka-peak. Hindi ko alam kung alam ng parents ko yun. Inside the house, if we're talking about the grilling, because it's one of the heated moments inside the house na naranasan ko. And I'm not that person who's ayoko ng confrontations, like I'm not good at that. I'm pretty sure na siguro they were asked to do this in exchange for something. Maybe they're doing that. So, for me, parang sa akin, okay. That's totally fine with me. I accept that kahit masakit. Yung sabi niya, akala ko ba no boyfriend since birth ka, pero ba't parang sanay na sanay ka? That's why I cried so much. Parang nasa isip ko noon, baka they took online comments and then they were just saying it. Baka finifeed sa kanila because they were reading something. Going outside, dun ko lang nalaman na parang, wait, yeah, it was kind of below the belt. Ang pinaka-ayaw kong sinasabi nila is if gumagamit lang ako ng tao. Na parang, lumalapit lang ako dito sa taong to dahil sikat siya. I wouldn't do that. Hindi ako pinalaking ganun. This week, honestly, like this week has been really hard for me. Like the bashing comments, it's like, una talaga hindi ako nagbabasa because I know na hindi naman totoo yun. Who's this person behind this profile picture? Diba? Na parang it's just a fake account, blah blah blah. But sometimes you can't help but read it. Sometimes nababasa mo na sabi lang, oh wait, it's a hate comment. So sometimes you can't stop yourself. And yeah, still now, from everything that happened inside the house, there are good and there are always gonna be bad things. I believe in yin and yang. There's no good without bad, there's no bad without good. So I accept that. Going inside the house, I knew that it was gonna happen. I did sa parents ko, but I didn't tell them yung specifics because I know I'm scared nung time na yun. I didn't know what to do. But I guess knowing more now, I wish I could've. But I guess it takes time for yung nabully na tao na to open up. The good thing about it is, I know myself. Na even before, parang I accepted myself. It was my father who told me that, lagi niyang sinasabi na no one's perfect. My parents, they always accept us. Kasi I was very insecure with my academic studies because I excel more sa art. And yung lagi sinasabi ng dad ko is, it's not always our academic status that will dictate the future, but rather, it's our personality, perseverance, commitment, and hard work. And those are the things you don't learn in school. I would talk to my friends, and then, paunti-unting tao. That's the thing. Nung nagkaroon ako ng problem, it's better to start with one person so people are aware why you're acting that way because they don't know. Hindi naman sila manghuhula para malaman na may problema kami. Sarili din silang problema. So I guess having that someone, that for me was my best friend. I still talk to her. Humingi ako ng advice from her. So she was bullied also when she was younger. Now she's the top model. We share the same interests. She's like me. I found someone who's like me. If I'm gonna change, it's only gonna be for the better. I won't change just because someone told me to. Just accepting everything about you, yung balat mo sa mata, your moles. I hated them before, now I love them. It takes time to love yourself, oh my gosh. And it takes a lot of bad moments and bullies. So I really do consider those bullying a blessing. Kung wala yun, I wouldn't be who I am now. Sometimes I think it's better to be bullied, to know yourself and know your worth. I'm stronger now. There will be times that it gets to me, but what matters the most is I always get back up and have people support me and know me. Kasi sila naman yung nakakakilala sa akin. I know myself. They know me. My family knows me. Yung mga opinion lang nila yung pakikinggan ko. And my fans, everybody. I'm very thankful for people who believed in me from the very beginning and people who just met me and still believed in me.